Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to color grade your footage to make it look like a Hollywood feature in these three quick, easy steps. All right, so I'm gonna show you how to do this in Adobe Premiere Pro. And you can use this in any other system. I'm just showing you how to do Premiere Pro. That's what I started it with, that's what I use. So first thing you wanna do with the new updates is that you can individually go into Lumetri. Now it's in settings and you can click the input LUT and you can convert your log footage over into, depending on what you shot, HGL or whatever you shot, high dynamic range, you can switch it over from log to Rec 709. But the fastest and easiest way of doing this is just go into the files and you wanna go down to project settings and you wanna go to colors. And once you do that, you want to click this button down at the bottom, automatically detect log video color space. Click that and every piece of footage that you bring into the system, it will automatically convert your log footage into Rec 709. We're just going to click OK. And as you can see, all of the footage has automatically converted over. If we go back up here and we take it off, you'll see it. It looks ashy. It turned it back into log. As you can see, it's back into log. To save time, just go ahead and click the project settings, color, and then click automatically detect settings if it's not. That's the quickest, easy way to do it. So we're trying to make it quick, fast edits and make things look good so we're not wasting too much time and we can turn this footage over back to the clients as fast as possible. And now we have everything in Rec 709 from log. So here's my footage. Now, after we do that, we want to go through each piece of footage to make sure that it's balanced the right way. Now, in Hollywood footage, they have lower tones, so the highlights aren't as super bright. So you want to bring all of that stuff down. You want to make sure that it's a little bit underexposed, just a little bit. And the way I like to do that is you can just go here and expose and just bring it down a little bit and then increase your contrast. That's going to make it look, give it that cinematic Hollywood feel. So the highlights aren't too bright and contrasty to make it look like digital footage. You want to bring down the highlights a little bit, and then once you do this, you see how it looks. Then you want to bring up the highlights just a taste. So I like to bring the exposure down, I like to increase my contrast, and I like to bring up my highlights just like that. Now this was shot on the Sony a7s3, and you can tell it looks good already. And I'm gonna go through each piece of footage and do the same thing. I'm gonna bring down my exposure, I'm gonna increase my contrast, and I'm gonna up my highlights just a little bit. And I'm gonna take just a taste, big back up right there. And I'm gonna go through each piece and do the exact same things. I'm gonna bring this down some, I'm gonna increase my highlights, contrast, just like that. And that's pretty much it. And that's good there. Same thing with this. This one's already dark, so I'm just gonna increase the contrast a little bit, bring up the highlights, exposure, and bring up the highlights just a bit. Just to give more detail to the highlights, it gives this punchy look that I like. So with this again too, I'm just gonna bring it down some to give it that Hollywood look, increase my contrast, and increase the highlights just a little bit, just to give it that nice crispy look, just a little bit right there. And I'm gonna do this with all my footage. Bring it down some, increase my contrast, and increase my highlights just a bit. And you can do this with curves as well. With curves, I like to go to the top here and I like to bring it down and then I like to bring it over. See that? I like to just bring down the highlights, make it so it doesn't look so digital, bring it over so it can bring back the contrast. A lot of people use the S curve, but I find that if your footage is overexposed like this, you can easily just go down in the bottom here of the curves and just slide it over and it'll automatically just dim the footage down a little bit. Or you can just come here and just bring it down some. If it's overexposed, just bring it down something like this. And then when you bring it down, just bring it over to bring back the crispiness so it can still have that sharp look without the highlights looking dull and dumped down. And so therefore, that looks good right there. Same right here. Highlights, can bring them down just like this. Make it look cinematic and then bring it over. See, just bring it over until you get that nice punchy look. But it also brings down the contrast that makes it look so digital. That's pretty much all I do. The very first thing I do is I make sure that the image is converted from S-Log to Rec 709. And then I start to adjust the exposure, and I adjust the white balance. So pretty much my white balance is all good on these images. I don't need to do anything else. Everything looks amazing. If you know how to proper white balance, then this one can be a little taste blue, but because it's in the desert, I'm just gonna warm it up a little bit more. And all of these images, I'm just gonna warm up just a taste, just because it's in the desert. And after you do that, that's pretty much all you need to do. Just warm it up a little bit, even though he's in the shadows, because usually the shadows are colder. And after you do that, you want to grab an adjustment layer. So let's go back to the project, grab an adjustment layer, and we're gonna take this adjustment layer and put it on top of all of our footage. Now the exposures and all that stuff, we're done. We're not touching anything else, that's done. Now we're just gonna put a LUT on top of it. It's super easy, it's super simple. There's a lot of people out here that's showing you how to do this and they're complicating it, but it really is easy. When you put your LUT on top, you wanna put your LUT on from the creative tab. You don't want to put your LUT on from the input LUT tab. You always want to go to the creative tab to put your LUT, your lookup on top of it. And I like to use one of my favorite places that's stress test. You don't have to go anywhere else for LUTs, is go to lensdistortion.com. Lens Distortion, if you want all your stuff to look cinematic, you want to use lensdistortion.com. For all of your LUTs. A lot of people have selling LUTs and telling you need this, you need these particular LUTs, you don't need none of that. Goes straight to Lens Distortion. I've been using them for the last 4 years on every single project that I use. You don't need any other LUTs. Once you put them on, they just work. So for this, I'm going to use, because it's in the desert, I'm going to use the Explore Till Finish. You can use that, and I'm gonna use the Explore Till 2. And as you can see, it automatically, if I get rid of it, it automatically gave it a style instantly. So we can take a look at it here, and if you take it off, add it on, as you can see, it automatically converted all of the colors. What I like about the Explore Till and Lens Distortion, and everything looks cohesive. And now you can see it has that Hollywood look. And all I like to do is just increase my sharpness a little bit and then increase my saturation just a tad, not too much, because I still want those colors to look rich and I still want it to be a premium look and sharp and clear, but I also don't want it to look digital. And as you can see, none of the footage looks digital. It looks like it was shot on Hollywood film. See, let's take it off and add it back on. See the subtleties, see the blues, see how it looks. It looks clean, it's clear, and that's all you do. Quick, simple, easy, beautiful footage. Let's get rid of it, add it back. As you can see, the colors are cohesive and it brings everything together, and it meshes really well. It blends out all those extra unnecessary colors and it makes your footage look amazing. And once you bring down those highlights, you'll have a cinematic look every single time. So that's how you color grade, those quick, easy steps. I hope that helps. If you want to see more tips and tricks on videos, just leave a comment below on what video I should do next. I'll plant you now, dig you later. APL signing off.